Our one owner from new Audi Coupe is going nowhere unless we can sort out its brake servo. I failed to fix it, but did Mike have better luck?
Elvis, parts delivery for you.
Is it the part? Is that the brake servo?
This is the brake servo that I've been trying to get from everywhere. Listen, I exhausted everywhere in the UK. There isn't one. So I went further afield and got this one all the way from Lithuania.
What, really? Wow, mate, well done. That's amazing, because I tell you what, you should have seen the state of the one that came off. It was horrible.
Yeah, 30 quid as well, cheap.
From Lithuania, yeah. Incredible. Yeah, nice one.
Right, now, whilst I was getting that, I've been thinking about the wheels and what we're going to do with them, because they need refurbishing, plus they're little fiddly wheels, aren't they, with all the nuts around the edge?
They definitely do need some attention, and they're not even real split rims. You know, they're sort of cheap, fakey, so we should do something with them.
Well, I've been talking to a company locally who reckon they can take our fakey split rim and turn them into genuine split rims. That gives them the option then, or us the option, to change the diameter of the rim, therefore changing the tyre size, and we could get a more fuel-efficient tyre.
That's amazing. I mean, yeah, you could have a bigger rim with a lower profile tyre, look better as well. It's a bit Vorsprung technique.
Exactly. So if you get that fitted, knock the wheels off, I'll take them with me.
Nice one, mate.
Nice one.
Oh, he's only gone and done it again, hasn't he? He's found me the one bit stopping me getting this car MOT'd and back onto the road. All I need to do is fit it, and then I can start thinking about updating that tech.
It's a like-for-like replacement, so, in theory, this should be very straightforward. And of course, the new servo fits in exactly the same way as the old one came out. I'm hoping it's the only thing I need to get this car through an MOT, but I won't know 100% for sure until I get out and drive it. So, Mike's going to have to wait a moment before I can give him those wheels. But until we pass the MOT, I can only test the new brake servo out on private roads.
Right, well, this is the first time that anyone's driven this car. Mike hasn't even driven this car yet. And there's always a tiny bit of nervous anticipation, particularly when you've done some major work on the brakes. I've got total confidence in my work. It doesn't stop me having that tiny little hint of not knowing what's about to happen when I press the pedal. Right, here we go. Oh, yes. That's exactly what I wanted to feel. A nice, controlled stop. No squealing, no juddering, no pulling off to one side or the other. Did exactly what I wanted it to do. And that means I can now get the car MOT'd and make it roadworthy. I've got to say, it drives really nicely. The car's quiet, it's smooth, it feels like a much more modern car than it is. Gear change has no lumps, no nasty noises, all the kind of things that you'd be looking for on a normal test drive before you bought the car. Of course, we didn't get the chance to do that because it didn't have any brakes. So I'm really pleasantly surprised with what I'm finding now. It's got all the hallmarks of the kind of car that you could use as a general everyday commuter. And if we can throw some additional tech at it, we could really bring it up into the modern day, couldn't we? I mean, I could get totally carried away with tech, but I do need to keep a check on what we spend on this car. I mean, look at it. It's so dated. It's so 1980s, isn't it? It's got a tape deck, for goodness sake.
Right, now I can whip the wheels off for Mike to refurbish.
Now, while Mike is off sorting the wheels out, it's given me a chance to take a closer look at this engine. And whilst it may not set your heart racing with excitement, it's a 2.2-litre five-cylinder engine, it is a good, solid basis. It's an interesting unit.
What's under the bonnet was great in the 80s, but with today's technology, I can take it up a notch. Well, to the next level, actually.
And this is the solution for closed-loop electronic fuel injection kits with an ECU right at the very heart of it. Now, that electronic control unit is continuously monitoring data coming from a series of sensors and uses it to calculate very accurately exactly how much fuel each cylinder needs at any given moment and under any given set of conditions. It's modern, it's high-tech, it's way more efficient, and it should mean that our car is now finally worthy of that slogan.
Ah, hello, mate.
Hello, mate.
Do you remember those old wheels you give me off the car, the fake split rims?
Yeah, that's not them, is it?
That is a genuine split rim, and that is the centre of our old wheel. It's been cut out and made into a proper split rim.
Cut and shut them.
Cut and shut them. How good is that,
eh? I like it. It looks
good. In fact, the Audi aficionados are going to love this, trust me. Not only that, there's been some progress through technology, because we've gone from a 15-inch rim up to a 16-inch rim.
Okay.
We've got a lower profile tyre. Before it was an F-rated tyre. Now it's an A-rated for efficiency tyres.
Mate, that fits in perfectly, because under the bonnet, I've also done that electronic fuel injection, which will also give us more fuel economy. And I've been shopping. Look at this. Best shopping trip ever. I've just been down the gadget shop and bought a load of tech.
Now I know why my phone app for the banking has began bing, 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 bing. It's you.
Yeah, all right, Dad. But I've bought some great stuff, and when I get it on the car, it's going to bring this Audi up to the modern era.
Well, listen, here's one. Let me go and get the others out of the car for you.
Nice.
Mike's new split rims and tyres are going to help the car's efficiency and transform the way this car looks. But it's the new driver's technology that I'm most excited about.
One of the first bits of tech that I'm going to fit to our car is reversing sensors. They weren't available as an option back in 1990, but today they are, and they're cheap.
At just £38 for the new sensors, it's a cost-effective way to bring this Audi into the 21st century.
Right, first job is to fit these four ultrasonic sensors, which sit in the rear of the bumper and then emit a cone of sound. And as that sound wave bounces back off a nearby object, the sensor picks that up and it detects how far away that object is. It lets you know as a driver by that little beeping sound you get in the cockpit. But I've got to situate these in a place where I can route the wiring nicely through the back of it, but also where they're nicely spaced apart and at exactly the right height so they work effectively.
I'm measuring up the bumper to accurately space out and position the sensors, then drilling small holes for them to sit into.
OK, with all four sensors now mounted in the bumper, I've just got to thread the wires through a hole that I've drilled and then feed them in where they'll get wired into the control box, which gets mounted just on the other side of this panel here.
The concept of ultrasonic sensors for spatial awareness has been around since the 1970s as a tool to help the visually impaired. But it wasn't until Toyota fitted them to the Prius in 2003 that they started to become common as a parking aid.
Now, the parking sensors take their trigger signal from the reverse lights. But before I wire those in, I've also got this little bit of kit here. It's a reversing camera and it wires into exactly the same circuit. So I'm going to stick this in at the same time.
Adding driver assistance technology is an easy way to improve the driver experience. It's also not that difficult to fit. So it's hard to go wrong, even if you're doing it on your own driveway.
Now, this may just look like a replacement rearview mirror, but it's actually a screen for that reversing camera, as well as having a dash cam built in as well. So once I've hooked this on, all I've got left to do is run a wiring harness from here all the way to the back and connect the whole lot up. Then I've got a new stereo to replace the old cassette deck in here, and we're nearly there. There we go. I love a bit of high technology, and with what I've done to this car, I've brought it way up into the modern era, hopefully on a budget that still means there's a profit in it too. I can't wait to reveal it all to Mike and to get it out on the road and give it a proper test.
I bought the car from Barry for £3,500. With delivery, the brake servo only set us back 34. I got the fuel injection kit for 880. The wheel rims and tyres cost 900. New efficient oil and spark plugs cost me 58. And the parking sensors, mirror and radio cost me a total of 228. Giving us a grand total of £5,600. Click here to subscribe.